What happens when you put a shark and a coyote together? Find out today on Jonathan Bird's Blue World with Coyote Peterson. Welcome to Jonathan Bird's Blue World.
Hey everybody, I'm in the Bahamas today, going out to have an epic adventure with tiger sharks. Now, I know that we've done that before, you've seen tiger sharks before, but today is something special. You've been asking for an incredible collaboration, and today it's gonna happen. Everybody, I want you to meet Coyote Peterson is coming with us on this trip.
What's up, John?
Hey, man. How are you?
I'm doing good. So this is the boat, huh?
This is the boat, and okay. We're going to have an epic tiger shark trip.
Now, I'm not going to get eaten, am I?
Well, we're going to try to keep you from getting eaten.
Okay, yes. You know, everybody's been asking, Coyote, are you going to get eaten by a shark, bitten by a shark? I'm going to do everything I can today to not be eaten or bitten
you know,
by a shark.
This is one of those animals that you don't want to encourage to bite.
Right.
Yeah, so we'll do it.
Permission to come aboard?
Come on, man.
All right, sweet.
All right, let's do it.
Okay, tiger sharks, here we come.
Today, I'm helping the Brave Wilderness team film the first episodes of their new series, Blue Wilderness. It will be hosted by Mark Vins, who's been producing Brave Wilderness with Coyote since the beginning. Their whole team has recently learned to dive, and this is their first big dive trip. Since they're new to diving and underwater filming, they came to me for some advice, and we decided to get together for a week-long dive adventure on my favorite dive boat, the Dolphin Dream. We have a lot planned for the week. Our first stop, tiger sharks. Our adventure begins in West End, Grand Bahama. We sail north across the Little Bahama Bank, a shallow area of mixed sand and reefs. It will take several hours to reach our destination, a large, shallow area called White Sand Ridge. Along the way, we have some time to relax, but it's not long before we stop for a warm-up dive. Mario, the Brave Wilderness cameraman, just got certified, and this will be his first dive since finishing his scuba class. Mark and Coyote have done a few dives, but they haven't been in the water in a while.
See, I've changed out my head attire from cowboy hat to youth-sized beanie, maybe? I don't know, that's what it feels like.
You look like a seal.
I actually find this is one of the more difficult aspects, getting the snorkel and mask tuned perfectly to getting in the water.
Final hydration. Here
we go. Make sure that's adjusted properly. That'll do it. Just tell you what, if you thought you were steamy before putting on the mask, just put on the mask and it intensifies.
All right, time to get in my BCD.
I hop in the water first to get some shots of Mark and Coyote jumping in. Coyote is going first, and I can tell he's a little nervous. Scuba is still new for him. But he does a perfect giant stride entry like a pro. Now it's Mark's turn. Mario has to film everything in his wetsuit, then join us in the water. After Mark is in, Mario joins us ready for action. We drop down to the bottom and there isn't really very much to see, just some sand and a few soft corals. But that's not the point. Coyote, Mark, and Mario need to get comfortable in their scuba gear before we add sharks to the mix. Mark also has a brand new Gates housing to figure out. And Coyote has camera envy. Soon everyone is ready and we head back to the boat.
So how was it?
Tough for me, every time. I'm like a fish out of water, in the water. But I think it was good to take just a warm-up dive, get acclimated to the environment, and now it's time to move the ship and get in with the sharks.
We pull anchor and head to Tiger Beach, which isn't actually a beach at all. It's the unofficial nickname for a shallow, sandy place far from land where they chum for tiger sharks. As soon as we arrive, the crew starts chumming to begin the process of attracting sharks. Then Captain Jared gives the group a dive briefing.
If you guys don't follow our suggestions for protocols and safe practice of diving, there's a very good probability that you will get bit. And from that, there is a very good probability that you will die about 6 hours from land and about 8 hours from actual medical care.
And after that cheerful speech, I have to reassure Mark and Coyote that they're going to be fine.
This is going to be so much fun. You're going to love this.
Okay.
Yep.
I'm hearing fun.
Yep.
Is it safe?
Well, yeah, it's pretty safe.
Pretty safe?
It's mostly safe.
Okay, mostly safe. What's the game plan? How do we stay safe?
So, we're going to wear gloves.
Okay.
Which keep your hands from looking like fish.
Sure.
And we're going to wear hoods, so we have this sort of ninja look.
Ninja?
Yeah, it keeps the sharks from thinking of us as having any food.
Does that make the sharks intimidated that we're like ninjas, or is that for color?
That is just to keep us from looking like anything edible.
Ah.
And when we hit the water, we're going to go straight down so we don't hang around the surface where prey would be.
Okay.
You know, we're going to get down to the bottom. And once we're down there, they think of us as just something that lives in the ocean and something competing with them for some food. So they're going to ignore you. You're going to love it.
Okay.
It's going to be fun.
Well, I'm excited. Coyote, how do you feel? Are you ready?
Got my giant camera rig ready, and I am 100% certain we're going to get in the water and get some epic shots.
After an hour of chumming, the boat is surrounded by sharks.
So when we pulled up, we immediately had sharks, which is always a really good sign, but there's a great hammerhead down there, and I'm really hoping that it sticks around, because it is so rare to see a great hammerhead here.
You know, you plan to
eat awesome. I'll meet you on the bottom.
See you down there, buddy.
Down on the bottom, there's a lot of action. Already, we have three species of sharks. Caribbean reef sharks, lemon sharks, and at least one nurse shark hanging around the chum box, plus about a zillion fish. Within a couple of minutes, Coyote and Mark are hitting the water, and things down below are in full swing. Then the first tiger shark shows up. And I'm pretty sure she just sneezed. And soon, the great hammerhead appears. This isn't just any great hammerhead. This is a friendly one that's been showing up at Tiger Beach a lot for the past 2 years. And they call her Patches for her patchy ventral coloration. Normally, hammerheads do not show up at Tiger Beach. Either they're afraid of the tiger sharks, or they're just too skittish around all the divers. But Patches is different. Patches is, in fact, so awesome, we're going to do an entire segment about her. The appearance of Patches and the tiger sharks means that we now have 5 species of sharks present on a single dive. And I'm pretty sure that Mario is super excited. I'm getting a kick out of watching Mark get comfortable with his new underwater camera. And I can tell he's in the zone where he's focusing on shots and his fear is gone. It's fun to be part of it and to see these guys falling in love with sharks right in front of my eyes. After an hour, we get a few last shots and then reluctantly head back to the boat. Nobody wants to get out of the water, but we're low on air. I can hardly wait to hear what they thought of the dive. But when I pop up, Mario has the camera ready and he wants to know what I thought of the dive.
Five species and one dive. I don't know if that's ever happened. To me, I mean, that's amazing.
So Coyote, that was the luckiest first shark dive in the history of diving.
Why, because I survived and wasn't eaten by the sharks, sir?
Five species of sharks, including a great hammerhead, on your first shark dive!
I mean, I don't know what's a good shark dive, because I've never dove with sharks before, so for me, I mean, being on the surface, and my immediate thought was, oh, cool, the sharks are right up at the surface. We should get the shots here. And then you get into the water, and there's definitely this moment where you walk to the edge of the boat, and I'm always concerned with my mask coming off, my regulator coming out of my mouth, and you kind of lose that moment when you say, okay, now I'm jumping into a pile of sharks. And I remember hitting the water, meaning, like, as soon as I opened my eyes inside my dive mask, everywhere, they're just all around you. And I looked straight down and I saw a huge tiger shark. Now the tiger sharks weren't up on the surface when we went into the water. So immediately I was thinking to myself, man, this is going to be epic. And once I got down there, found myself in the bottom, found all of you guys, orientated myself, got comfortable with the environment. I said, okay, take a deep breath, start getting those shots. And man, I'm not sure I've ever filmed anything more epic underwater than I have tiger sharks and of course that great hammerhead. What a treat that shark was.
Super cooperative. Multiple passes right over the camera. Dude, that is beginner's luck for shark diving if ever there was.
Okay. I mean, I'll take it. I certainly didn't expect to see a great hammerhead. And the tiger shark's impressive, the lemon shark's impressive, the other species that we saw, but that great hammerhead is so big and it's got that gnarled front jaw. You just see the teeth sticking out, and every time it would turn its head with one of those big eyes staring at you, all I could think of was, okay, just keep swimming, don't come towards me. I'm a friend, not a foe, not food. Just keep going, right. And then you get the shot.
It was epic. Thank you for coming.
Jonathan, thank you so much for featuring me on the channel today. I'm thrilled to be here, and I'm glad that my presence supposedly brought all these cool sharks in front of the cameras, but it was certainly a day to remember.
Well, we're bringing you on all our shark dives now.
Sounds great. Next up, great white sharks?
Yeah,
right?
Sure thing.
Out of the cage?
Yeah.
All right, I'm ready.
As the sun sets, we're already looking forward to tomorrow, because things are about to get even more wild.
Don't go away. You don't want to miss Coyote making friends with a tiger shark.
The next morning, the boat is swarming with sharks. But we're doing a shark feed, so we have to jump into this mass of sharks and swim down quickly to the bottom. Hit the water and head over to the sandy area where the feed will take place. Coyote and I are first on the scene. Soon Houston arrives with the bait box. The sharks know the deal. They immediately come over and start circling, waiting for the free breakfast to start. Mark arrives with his camera ready. As Houston starts feeding, Mario, Mark, and Coyote are all keeping a safe distance, with cameraman Tim filming from behind them. I'm keeping my camera trained on Coyote, just in case something interesting happens. Interesting things always seem to happen to Coyote. Meanwhile, Finch has taken over the feeding with his traditional silly shark feeding outfit. As the feed goes on, more and more sharks come to the party. Coyote and Mark get more comfortable moving closer and closer to the action. Then the sharks come around to investigate. Mark has a close encounter of the sharky kind. But he handles it calmly, no problem. Coyote is getting right up close with his camera. Then Coyote has his own close encounter. And he recovers like a pro. This was not an act of aggression from the shark. It was just investigating Coyote to see if he had any food. You don't need to read sign language to understand what he's saying. That is one big tiger shark. At the end of the dive, we all head back to the boat to celebrate. We took the Brave Wilderness team shark diving, and Coyote didn't get bitten by anything. Mario and Mark got some valuable experience filming underwater for their new series, Blue Wilderness. And guess what? We're planning a bunch of upcoming collaborations between Blue World, Blue Wilderness, and Brave Wilderness. So stay tuned for more awesome underwater action in the Blue World. Hey everyone, thanks for watching our latest episode all the way to the end. You're crazy if you don't subscribe. Hit that subscribe button now so you won't miss our next episode. And check out our merch link in the description for some Blue World swag.